infamous cup. This intro, that's why I let it play. We talk about Prog, and I just thought, well, I haven't really played any Prog music in many of my videos in a long time, and so I thought I'd play a little bit of Premiata Forneria Marconi, probably one of the most famous Italian progressive rock bands from the 70s, who I understand are still going. And these are originals that I have here of these, or at least with their Italian pressings. I'm playing the CD for convenience. I also have it on. I have several more PFM on vinyl. I just pulled these. So it's got that folky medieval thing going on here, but in a second they're gonna bust it out and just jam it out. And I just love that about good progressive music. Not the stuff where it's noodles for noodles' sake, but like this. This is some fine-ass music. There's really no disputing it, is there? Fantastic. I really didn't pull records to show. I just woke up with the idea that I wanted to just say something about Prog and play something since some of us love Prog and played it in a while. What's on my plate today? Because that's kind of, again, like I say, making these videos is as much a diary as anything. Well, a couple things, actually, up to date, because this is also the way I do business. It's all rolled into one. Isn't this kind of cool? I am down to, let's see here. Literally, I am down to 1, 2, 3, 4. To 18 copies left of Sonospheres, whatever you say. 18 copies left. Thank you for the feedback, people letting me know. Yeah, I got knocked it out of the ballpark with this one, with Sonospheres. You know, people letting me know that this is the art of mine that they appreciate the most. I started out with Dereck 3 and Dereck 2, trying to share my music and my songs, and I love my music, but this is my art. This is the soundscapes. That's my claim to fame, I guess you could say. It's what I'm doing that is of note. And let me tell you, folks, Sonospheres 2 kicks its ass. I am so proud of Sonospheres 2. Matter of fact, that's what I'm up to today. Today I will be getting together with Aaron Gum from Indrima, who is a computer wizard, and he's going to put together the template for my art today, and I'm going to put in the order for Sonospheres 2 today. Some other personal news. Yesterday I was interviewed by Kyle Eustace, who is actually the daughter of my bass player when I had the Dereck Higgins band. You know, if I were ever to revive it again, Bill would, of course, want to play. But his daughter, Kyle, is a rock journalist, and she writes for Filter, and recently she got a gig with Wax Poetics. She interviewed me yesterday for about the upcoming In Dreama show, and I really enjoy being interviewed, especially I like being interviewed when the questions are interesting. I think I'm like any other artist, that when you're interviewed by someone who obviously doesn't know a fucking thing about music or what you're about, that sucks. But Kyle comes from a musical family, you know, when she was a little baby, a little girl, she was in the company of Bob Dylan, among other people, okay, because of her dad. A lot of amazing stories. But anyway, she asked me some great questions. I don't know how it will be edited, but when the article comes out, I'll post a link to it online on Facebook. Part of what came up in the video, or part of the interview, or part of what was said in the interview, kind of relates to some things that people have been saying to me in the video responses, which is, people tell me all the time, well, I don't know if you know it, Dereck, but you are the Mac Daddy, or you're a legend, or you are the capo di capo, and all this stuff. And the thing is, that's very flattering, and it's nice to hear it. But the thing that I have learned from observing mankind very closely is that we foolishly believe that stuff. When we let it go to our heads, this happens all the time, and it destroys the magic. And I just see it so clearly, so I'm not gonna do it. Thank you, but I know that ain't true. I'm just Dereck over here in his house doing what he's always wanted to do and has always loved to do the most. Play records, talk about records, talk about life, muse on life. Those are two of my favorite things in life. They are. And so I'm not getting a swell headed about people enjoying my company and what I have to say. I'm glad you do. The last thing I want to do is become like these rich bitch motherfuckers, like the Rockefellers and like the Rothschilds and the Whitneys and the all these people who are running game behind the scenes, who don't give a motherfuck about anybody because they're so isolated because of their power. These are the things I'm railing about in my comments. Ultimately, is I'm railing about how man seems to be asleep to his own worst part of his human nature. I'm aware of the worst part of my human nature, and I refuse to act on it. I know it's there, and it hasn't gone anywhere because it's a part of me, but I recognize it, and it's like I'm not here to create havoc and destruction on this planet. I mean, I have in the past, and it's like I woke up to it, it's like, oh, this ain't cool. I got something better to offer here. But our so-called world leaders, the Trilateral Commission and all those people, you know, they are up to no fucking good, people. Like there's anything we can do about it, but I think you ought to know. And I just muse on that, thinking that, you know, I must be a halfway decent person, because I don't even want to be tempted with that shit, because it seems like everyone that gets tempted with it goes down. One more thing, and I'll go back to music, guys. I've been saying on Facebook very clearly, you know, that there's a lot of evidence about how the country is being run by Satanists. That, you know, the Dems and the Republicans, it's all a facade. I mean, there's a lot of information. I also have personal experience going way back, that which is why I'm so adamant about this. I've experienced the corruption of power firsthand, okay? And, oh, man, you know, it's why I say these things. It's like, you know, man, you know, the idea that, you know, power seems to just absolutely corrupt, you know. It's like you get so rich you can do anything you want, and you literally do. I'm down with that. So, thank you for the compliments. It's not going to my head because I see what happens when it goes to people's heads. It's why I can't stand to listen to Kanye West. He is a good producer, but he pisses me off. Here's another. I've derided Kiss because they are literally a shitty musical band. They're not good. But here's a band that is good, but I won't buy them. Well, because it's mainly not what I'm into, but I recognize that they're... What a band. Pantera. Okay? I don't have no Pantera. But Dimebag, whoo, what a guitar player. The drummer, what was the drummer's name? When they played, and then Phil, I mean, as a frontman, he's great, but you can tell that he has a lot of growing up to do. I would hope that maybe since I've, you know, I don't keep up with the kid and the man. Maybe he has. But you know what I'm saying? That's an example of a band that a lot of people love that, yeah, those guys deserve it. Pantera is a real band. Kiss have worked hard, but they suck. Why do I do this so much, particularly to those guys? Because it just it upsets me how people are just hoodwinked and fooled by crap. Life could be a lot better. Those guys could have done some service with all their money and power, but they don't. They just fuck chicks. Okay, so PFM, I love them. Italian prog rock, I love it. I wish I could afford more. Prog rock in general, I love. Like this song here, this is so beautiful. Well, let's listen to the beginning of this again. Is there for you to hear. It's not that you have to like it, but you can recognize this is quality. Somebody needs to be telling the children about quality, not just getting their motherfucking money.